abonnieren. Bis du startest dann in Brandschandau.
Yeah, so here we are in Berlin. We're heading towards the main city. I've got to remember to always stay on the right-hand side of the road here because I often just veer to the left. Anyway, it's a great city so far. I've only been here 2 hours. It's beautiful, a lot to see, a lot to do. I think I'll pretty much take off now and go down the bottom foreshore and have a look at that. But yeah, welcome to Berlin, guys, and Andrew Penman, EBoard Reviews YouTube. There we go. Okay guys, here we are in Berlin. I've arrived finally, check it out, this is it. I'm in the city and I don't know where, I've got to find the river, I think it's down this end. You can't ride electric skateboards in Berlin, it's far too dangerous. The cops are everywhere. A guy got fined yesterday, 3,600 euros for riding. But I'm going to head down the river on the Lime scooter. I've just hired one. I'm going to check it out and I'm going to head down there and take some drone footage. I might get some drone footage of this sucker later on as well. Then I'll head over to Franky Sommer. He's one of the leading pioneers of longboard riding and electric skateboard riding, who I first found 5 years ago, which really encouraged me and motivated me and inspired me to do electric skateboard reviews. So we'll see Franky. He's a legend, longboard rider, world champion, European champion, and electric skateboard shop there in Longboards DE. Let's go riding, and we're in Berlin, and let's check it out. Okay guys, these Lime scooters are friggin' insane. You can ride bikes like this, bike tour, but I'm just doing my own thing on my own. So yeah, these scooters are pretty friggin' insane. They get around 20 kilometers an hour and you can get to see everything. So. They're so easy to ride, so much fun. I've got my selfie stick on there now. Why would you bother electric skateboard riding when you can just take a Lime scooter? Here we go, in Berlin. One-handed scooter riding, pretty good talent if you can do it. German waffles, check this out. They are friggin' amazing. Dudes, here we are at the Brandenburg Gate. Check it out. This is the old divide of the cities, where the cities had two entrances, and this is the one here. If you look around, you can imagine the armies and the Third Reich, and you can see the Weimar and all the troops. It's quite an historic city, actually. I'm really... yeah, really impressed with Berlin. I've got to hear something really funny. A paparazzi guy is going around taking photos of looking at famous people. I think Brad Pitt's in town, so is Margot Robbie and Quentin Tarantino and Leonardo DiCaprio. So he looked at me and took a photo. He must have thought I was someone famous. I've just got a common face that people just remember or look very similar to somebody else. It's hilarious. Get into this every day. Check this out. A juggler on the street. Hilarious. Hilarious. Haha, love your work. I'm about to head down to a place called Longboard DE, where a guy called Franky Sommer has a shop. It's my travel board there, my SHAKABOARD. I'm not going to carry this. You can hear the bells everywhere in Germany. It's pretty incredible. Look around, it's an awesome spot. Here we are, guys. We're in Berlin, and I'm at Franky Sommer's Longboards DE shop, as you can see there. This guy was one of the great pioneers of longboard riding, world champion. He's done a lot of stuff in the industry. He was the guy that got me into electric skateboard riding literally, you know, 7 years ago, and I watched one of his videos on the river here in Berlin on an Onan, and that's what started me. So we're gonna go and have a chat to Franky and have a look at his shop, and he's an absolute legend and a real big trailblazer and pioneer in this industry, including electric skateboard riding. So this will be a small snippet in this particular vlog in Germany, in Berlin, and we'll be actually doing a full video on Franky on the next available vlog, which I'll put on so you can see it all. So here we are. Yeah, it's pretty warm today, and we'll go and have a look now and have a chat to Franky. Right, here we go. Here we are in Germany. Now I'm in Berlin, and this is a guy who I saw for the first time riding a board, electric skateboard, about 6 years ago, and here he is, Franky Sommer. Franky Sommer is a legend in the industry. We'll talk a little bit about what you're a longboard professional, and you tell us a little bit. He's very humble.
It's very easy. This is my company, and I don't give a fuck. And you know why? Easy. Longboarding is come from skateboarding, but skateboarding and longboarding, there's no big difference, because a longboard, it's only a longer skateboard.
That's exactly right.
So we have in the world big trouble, because the skateboarders hate the longboarders.
That's right.
The longboarders love the skateboarders. So I try to bring them together, because if you see gravity, skateboarding.
And Franky, I saw on a video riding along Berlin on a river, and that sort of got me in about 7 years ago. And so pretty much this has been the original. So Franky has been in the industry more than anyone, and he's been doing this stuff before anybody, and really one of the leaders, haven't you?
I think it's more than 23 years right now.
Yeah.
The point is, this shop, it's since 20 years open. It was from the very first beginning a longboard shop and not a skateboard shop. It turns then to a longboard shop, so that's fine. Don't do that. And the thing is, what he say, the video on the river.
Yeah, that was amazing.
Can I show you the board?
Yeah, let's show the board. Let's go.
So I think 7-8 years ago, it starts actually with this drive.
Oh my God, hang on. So this, what you're about to see, guys, is one of the first electric skateboards for a long time ever been built. Well, how many years ago did you build this, Frank?
Yes. 7 years ago, so whatever.
Franky built this literally 8 years before Boosted, before Evolve, before even probably Fix skateboards. And look at this, still running. You got the box?
Yeah, so there's actually the AC, it's the member monster inside from Castle.
Oh my
it's
God.
It's so powerful. I have 5,000 up to 10,000 milliampere accus.
Wiggle around it. I'll edit that out. Oh my God. Yeah. It holds the whole battery. That is like military grade Velcro. That's insane.
So I'll never get a problem.
That's insane. I can't believe it. Now, you've got to remember, guys, this skateboard is way before Boosted, way before Evolved. This is the one of the first boards, I think, it was pretty much out
I
there.
I think it is do-it-yourself boards.
Yeah, you know? Exactly.
In this time where the people do-it-yourself. You know what I'm doing right now with this?
What's that?
I show you. I have a piece of wood, yeah, and actually I put...
No way, it's a sander.
Because I put grip tape on it. And so it's so great for sanding.
Oh, it's brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. So really, we know that this is supersedes anything that was pretty much made at the time. We're talking, you know, like 7-8 years ago. This is just incredible. And that helmet there, I saw you riding that in a video 6 years ago. Now, 6 years ago, guys, remember, no one was riding electric skateboards. No one was even reviewing them, but Casey Neistat and also Franky, myself, and a few other people, Sam Sheffer and Port Electric Vehicles. But that was the industry back then. So we're like the forefront of this kind of pioneers in the sport. So congratulations, Franky, for that. It's amazing.
I am professional slalom skateboarder.
That's right. And tell us about you won some world titles, haven't you? Some contests.
Yeah, but my slalom skateboard is from Pavel. It's a German producer,
yep.
You know, and the design was a zebra design.
I love it.
And then I saw the TSG and zebra.
I love TSG, the
and
best
helmets. So this is why I have this helmet.
So here he is with all his entries and contests.
No, this is from Kozakov from 2011,
wow.
Then the Gigabyte Mastership. Let's see what's happened. This is the arm up treat, the world championship.
Wow, incredible.
And
I must point out that Frankie's in the middle of doing a massive renovation here, and this is already a memorabilia of history here, and this including a skate. There's a skate ramp down here. Yeah. You're a crazy man. You're as crazy as me. We're the world's oldest teenagers. Frankie is 57. I'm 58. So there's some motivation for you guys. It's an amazing contribution you've made, Franky, to the industry of longboard and onto skateboarding. Yeah.
Oh, that's beautiful.
Yeah. So I'm here for 3 days. Just spent a little bit of time having a chat to Franky and his shop. That was awesome. But there's the river here. It's not the world's greatest spot at the moment, but it's probably the safest place to ride at the moment. Based on, I don't want to get my skateboard confiscated. This is the foundations of the original church, and we've got one of the foundations there. This is the original wall. Okay, I've ridden the lime scooter right to the wall. There's a spot here you can just see through this gap. Now there is, if I can get the focus, the original wall. There you go. That's the original wall. East Germany and the Soviets said it was to keep capitalism out, and they keep the East Germans safe. There you go. That's the original wall. I'll try and zoom in. There you go, you can see it. There's a memorial above it. I'll go around there and check that out, but there you go, that's the actual wall. So there you have it. The existing wall went from here right across to here and continued behind this fortification, which the original wall is still there. And if you want to, you can go upstairs to the memorial, as you can see there. And check it out from the top, the lookout up there, and up there. And I'm standing now in East Berlin, and now I'm standing in West Berlin, just across the border. From 1961, the year I was born, till 1989, I think it was, this was sectioned. We're here in the museum, Dinosaur Museum. This is probably, the most advanced dinosaur museum I've ever seen in my life. Check this out. These are the real size of them. Insane. Check that out. Huge. I think it's where they film Night at the Museum. They have to. It's an amazing location. Beautiful old building. Check this out. Look at this. This is just raw from the ground. Can you believe that? Check the size of it. Unbelievable. I'm 100% they're snow leopards. Now, just to let you know, I've got a skin of a snow leopard and the full head. I found at an auction in a garage sale, which is worth probably priceless. And yeah, it's got the full head, everything, and it's 1910 was shot, so it wasn't extinct then, so I've got a skin. But here they are, nearly extinct in the museum exhibition of the endangered species stuff. Incredible. Scary, eh? There's the SHAKABOARD. I got my German socks on, and there's the beautiful sights of here we go. There's the SHAKABOARD. I'm in Germany, as you can see, and this is no trick photography. I wouldn't be doing this normally. It's pretty damn dangerous. Anyway, guys, here we are in Berlin. Okay guys, I'm in Berlin. I'm about to do something a little bit sketchy, a little bit dangerous. Electric skateboards are completely banned in Berlin, but I'm going to do a run past the dome here. That's the Berlin Dome. So let's go. Let's have a run. Okay guys, look around in 360. You'll see how pretty this is and how beautiful this is. So here we are in Berlin. This is one shot at this, because if the cops catch me, they'll take my skateboard. Have a look around. Look at this, guys. It's awesome. Berlin. This is the Deutsche Dome. You can see just next to me. And yeah, if I get caught now, I'm gonna lose my skateboard for sure. Anyway, welcome to Berlin on my channel, Andrew Penman YouTube. Electric skateboard riding, to the dude with the saxophone. You don't get that stuff anywhere else. Well guys, that's it. I won't do any more than this, is too risky. But that's the Deutsche Dome in the square in Berlin, riding my electric skateboard. Guys, thanks so much for joining me on this amazing trip on this. Let's go around here a bit, and then I'll just head down here. But what an amazing adventure Berlin's been. I've been riding around on my Lime scooter. It's been incredible. Had the best time ever. Look at these buildings. Just look around. It's just insane. I don't recommend anyone doing this in Berlin if you don't want to lose your skateboard or end up in jail. The guys are pretty serious around here. And they fined a guy yesterday €3,500 with no headlight, no steering wheel, no no anything. So I want to pull over soon and just call it a day. Anyway guys, that's it. So thanks for joining me on this Berlin run. We had a great time. Thanks so much. I'll just turn left here actually before it's just the last turn here, and I'll go home now along here. Yeah, look, this is amazing. It's a beautiful city. It's incredible to come and ride, but you're not allowed to. You will lose your skateboard for sure. I'm doing this on Thursday night about 8:30 at night, so I wouldn't recommend anyone else doing it. But it's certainly an amazing city to come and visit. So big shout out to my subscribers in Berlin, and a big shout out to Franky Sommer, which you saw the interview with. It was fantastic. And I'll head off now to Prague, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Until then, it's Andrew Penman over and out before I get busted. Well, that was a lot of fun. A little bit sketchy. Here I am. Look, life as a YouTuber, traveling world is not what it's made out to be. It's a lot of hard work. If you think of doing YouTube, guys, I'm sitting here in Berlin having a Vietnamese with no one around. So it's one of those things where you, if you think of being a YouTuber, is a lot of work for no money, pretty much. So I wouldn't get too excited about this. If you're into sort of working hard, if you're into working hard and trying to, you know, juggle stuff, it's probably the right thing for you. But here at Vietnamese food in Berlin, it's been a great day, had a great time. I'll definitely check in with you guys next vlog, which will be Prague, and we'll head back down the coast, down to sort of like Milan in Italy, and head up in Rome. But I'll get a lot of skating done then, because it's allowed to ride, so it'll be fine. So guys, thanks for watching this vlog on Berlin, and I'll catch up with you guys in the next one, and I'll see you then. Okay, I just finished my meal, and it was absolutely unbelievable. If you're in Berlin, guys, you gotta check this out. It's Sampa Restaurant in Berlin. See Jana and Kilmi. They are the girls here. They will provide the best service, but the food is the best Vietnamese I've ever had in my life. So yeah, thoroughly recommend it. So check it out when you come to Berlin. And big shout out to the guys. Thank you very much, girls, who did a great job. And hey, we're just about to get off in Prague. Wow. Okay, what would happen if I... What? Jeez, those doors annoy me. What would happen if I push these buttons here, turn this knob here, turn that knob, push that button, push those buttons, pull that round, and touch the screen a few times, do you reckon? Do you reckon that would do something to the train? I think I'd probably get kicked off pretty quick. You're still here? Cool. Listen, why don't you watch some of these other videos I've made in the past along the same lines of what you just watched, in the same kind of category. Enjoy.